Animal sounds coming from a high school theater usually are concerning, but if you happen to walk by at Bishop Chittard High School, don't worry. Students are just getting ready for their upcoming production of Charlotte's Web. A children's book adaptation seems an odd choice for a high school play, but director Jennifer Klee says it makes more sense than you might think.
The more research we did on Charlotte's Web, the more we fell in love with just different set designs that we saw and the story. The beautiful thing about really all children's theater, I think, is that even though it's geared toward children, there are just lessons there.
While she and the creative team were excited, they weren't sure how the students would receive the play. Klee says they were actually enthusiastic because it is such a beloved book. Parents, like Christine Janowitz, were also excited because of their fond memories of Charlotte's Web from their childhoods.
Of course, I'd heard of Charlotte's Web, and in fact, I remember having my third grade teacher read it to us, and then we would alternately read one chapter. And I thought it was a great idea. I love the book. The thing I'm most enthusiastic about is, I think, how they're going to translate animals into on stage.
Christine's son Jackson plays Templeton, one of the lead characters in the play. Jackson says he's excited to be doing a show that will appeal to a wide range of people in the audience.
I realized that we would appeal to a younger audience, and they would really love it a lot. And they would love the characters a lot, and seeing their faces after the show would be a lot better than seeing a normal person's after any other normal show.
Jackson agrees with Klee that with Charlotte's Web, there is more than meets the eye.
It's not just a children's show that actually... It actually has a message behind it. It's a really good metaphor in that it shows how friendship can change things and how a life of one small being can change a bigger overall concept.
This is Rebecca Harris reporting for The Beat.